Hello, Kingdom citizens. Welcome to Login 2.0. My name is Denzel Rodriguez, your fellow Kingdom citizen, and I would like to read to you our vision and our mission statement of Login 2.0. So the vision of Login 2.0 is to create an inclusive and authentic environment to explore matters of faith. And our mission of Login 2.0 is to empower generations to celebrate Christ, share His love, and engage communities to transform lives to become faithful disciples of Christ. That is our mission here on Login 2.0. My role is simply to make videos. That's my thing. I'm a content creator, will always be a content creator, and I want to bring to you helpful tools and tips that you can use and implement in your life to live a better life, number one, get closer to God, hear His voice, learn your purpose in life so that you can fulfill it and help others do the same, okay? That's like my personal mission. And I have aligned myself with Login 2.0 so that we can do something big together, all right? And I like to get involved in things that are radical, just different, out of the blue. Okay, so with that being said, today we're going to talk about just basic facts about money. At any point in time, I encourage you to check out the links below in the description. We have a bunch of events planned, dated, time, everything on our website, Eventbrite, and in the description below. Would love to meet you in person and we can communicate. Pray together, worship together, learn together, grow together, and give together. Oh yeah. So with that being said, let's direct our attention to the board. Some basic facts about money. I just want to lay out some things that you probably didn't even think about the true cost of different stuff over the course of a lifetime. All right. So I'm going to start with the first one. Medical. Health insurance, medical bills, going to the doctor, emergency rooms, getting sick. Over the course of an average lifespan, you'll pay about $300,000 to $361,000 just on medical bills. How crazy is that? Right? This is in the US. This is the average lifespan. For women, it will be higher than men simply because women live longer than men. So the 361 is for women, the 316 is for men, okay? About the average family will spend about a half a million to about 700,000 on vacations, okay? This is your whole lifetime from when you, say, are 15 all the way till you're in your 70s, okay? And that is just an average. These numbers, by the way, none of these are gonna be spot on accurate, but I'm just giving you the depth of how large these expenses are in your personal finances throughout your whole entire life. This way you can see what you're up against and how to tackle it. And I'm gonna explain how I personally tackle looking at this, how I make sense of it, and how I can proceed with my life. This way I don't get trapped. I don't become a slave to money, all right? So the next one is that the average person will spend about $1 million on rent, mortgages throughout their whole entire life. Next one is food. $300,000 to $900,000 you'll spend on food during your lifespan here in the US. You'll pay about $1 million in taxes. Tax rate currently 23.8%, I think, is average. And can go as high as 33.7. It can go even higher than that. By the way, taxes will continue to rise every single year, no matter what. The next thing is tithing and giving. The average person gives about 5 to 10% per year. So whatever that number is for you and your income, you'll be able to get a solid number. But that number as well will continue to increase. Inflation is 2 to 3% here in the U.S., every single year. So what that basically means is that the cost of everything, and I didn't even put everything on here, right? I left out so much stuff. I'm just giving you some, Can you imagine if we put did it all? I'd need the whole board, right? But this inflation, what basically means is you can just take the current number, say the first year you spend, I don't know, $3,000 on medical. Well, the next year you can just times it by 2%. So it'll go up. Same thing with rent, food, cost of living, household, debt, everything. Everything will continue to rise about 2 to 3% inflation. Okay? And the last thing, this is super important. Money has no value. What does that mean? What that really means is that the US dollar is not tied to anything. It is simply the word of the US government that says this dollar is worth a dollar. This $5 bill is worth $5. This is 10, that's 20, that's 50, that's 100. But there's nothing backing up that money to prove that this is worth a dollar or five or 10, 20, 50, $100. Okay? So if money has no intrinsic value, that means it is a fiat currency. That means it'll fluctuate. Today it'll be worth something, tomorrow it'll be worth another. It doesn't retain its value. Meaning, today you'll go to Macy's, you'll buy a suit for $250. Okay? 5 years from now, that same suit will cost, say, $500. Well, the money, that $250 that you originally had, 5 years from now, even though the price of something is worth $500, like that's what it costs, your money, you'll need more dollars to pay for a specific thing. Whereas when we look at gold, right, say an ounce of gold today is, I don't know, I think it's like 1500 plus an ounce of gold, okay? $1,500 for an ounce of gold buys me $1,500 worth of goods. 5 years from now, 10 years from now, 20 years from now, that same ounce of gold will retain its value. So no matter what happens to the economy, doesn't matter, this gold will continue to increase in value. It'll retain its value throughout the years. It is what we call the hedge against inflation, because the cost of that suit will continue to rise each and every year. So that $250 suit, however much gold it would cost to pay for that suit today, 10 years down the road, that gold will be worth the same amount in weight to purchase that suit, okay, or an asset or whatever analogy you want to use, okay? So basically gold retains its value, whereas the US dollar will dwindle away. It does not retain its value. It has no value. It's not tied to the gold. It was removed back in the 70s, I think. Gold was removed from the dollar, which is why you see a large amount of debt here in the US. I think we're 24, 23 plus trillion in debt. So what's happening now is that the cost of everything just keeps going up. Yet your income is stagnant. How you get paid, hourly, salary, commission, however. So here's how I combat inflation, taxes, having to give, and the cost of goods rising, and all that good stuff. Is let me give you my numbers back in the day when I was a young buck. I'm still a young buck. But you know, when I was a little bit younger and less knowledge in my brain, I was making about $2,000 a month. $1,500 was my expenses. Had about $20,000 in debt. Cash flow was about $500. Okay. So once I learned about this, about the true cost and over the long haul of things and assets and giving and taxes and all that good stuff, instead of trying to make sense of this, I simply said, well, how do I rise above it? How do I rise above this system so that I can operate in God's kingdom here on earth? And I simply said, well, What if I made this 2,020? How do I go from making 2,000 a month to 20,000 a month? And for me, it was very simple. All I needed to do was provide value to the marketplace, right? That's all I needed to do was provide value to the marketplace. I need to trust God that He will make room for me, like He says, that my gift will make room for me on this earth, right? So I got to trust in God first. I got to seek His kingdom first. Then He provides me, because He's the source, so He provides me with a resource, basically my spiritual gifts, okay? So He exposes my spiritual gifts to me. He then gives me purpose to execute those spiritual gifts here on earth. And in return, the monetary value here on earth is money. So I receive money from people, lots of people, because I gave them value in the marketplace. I trusted God. He gave me spiritual gifts. He provided me purpose to provide that value to people. And the people exchange money and they give it back to me. And then now, all I gotta do is simply live and operate the same way as if I was living on $2,000 a month, right? And of course, by making more and more money, it's wise to then make the transition from the E and the S side. Instead of being an employee and self-employed, I transition to the B and the I side, because I can create, multiply time, save money on taxes, and maximize my income potential. Because on this side, I'll cap out on what I can make. But on this side, the income potential is infinite. There is no caps as a big business owner or an investor. Okay? So I make that transition. I continue to provide value to the marketplace. I continue to trust God. None of this is no longer an issue. All of this will make sense. Because bringing in $20,000 a month, right? And let's say it took 2 years to go from 2,000 to 20,000. In my particular situation, it took me about 10 months. But let's just say it took me 2 years, right? All right. Well, then in my mind, I'm like, well, shoot, if it took me 2 years to 10x my income, go from 2,000 a month to 20,000 a month, who's to say I can't do it again to go from 20,000 a month times 10 to 200,000 a month? Then things just seem like, wow, you know, what, 300,000 in miracle? Half a million vacations? Million in taxes? Tithing? I'll do 15, God. I'll do 20, right? It's no longer an issue. You're no longer bound by money because you tapped into your spiritual gifts. God provided you purpose. You're trusting in God when it comes to money. And He's going to tell you how to provide value to the marketplace. He can tell you directly. Boom. Just listen to Him. Listen to His voice. He'll tell you. Read His word. He'll tell you. Okay? And then you go out into the world and you analyze what type of environment you're living in and what type of education can you accumulate. Financial literacy is going to be one of the biggest things that you're going to want to accumulate knowledge on so that you know how to allocate the funds. What to do with the money once you 10x the money. Me personally, after I 10x, went from 2,000 to 20,000, I'm trying to master my craft now. I'm like, okay, I got something going. I save 40% of that 20,000. And instead of just saving it, having it sit in cash, that's going to lose value, right? What do? I shift that money in gold, silver, and assets, being real estate, a business, a product, a service, assets, things that produce income, activity, things that produce what we call cash flow continuously, whether I work or not. It'll just keep coming in. This creates time for me. This creates more time to tap into my purpose, to provide value to the marketplace, and just rinse and repeat. Rinse and repeat. keep hearing God's voice. It gets clearer and clearer and clearer every single day. God's voice, God's path gets easier and easier to see. But as long as I stay in financial troubles, it's going to be harder for me to hear and see exactly what I need to be doing. So here are some just basic facts about money. Take it how you want, but I can tell you, I speak for myself always, that once I made that transition, once I changed my ways of being around money, once I improved my relationship around money, and then I deemed it that I will no longer be a slave to money, that I shall rule over money, and then God shall rule over my life, in that order, it eliminates the chaos, and I'm able to hear God's voice a lot better. So hope this was helpful to you. My name is Denzel Rodriguez. Have a wonderful day, and God bless.